Welcome back, children.
Next is 12th question. In that A question, let me read the question, children. Divide 180 into two parts, which are in the ratio 3:2. So they have given the ratio and they have given some total number. Okay, some total they have given. Okay, that is the sum actually. That we should divide it into two parts, which are in the ratio 3:2. So in this ratio, which is the first term, children? The first term of the ratio is 3. Okay, and what is the second term, children? The second term, it is equal to 2. Okay, what we should find? We should find both the parts, correct? So first part, when they give you the parts like this, you should apply this formula, children. In order to find the first part, your formula is first term, okay, divided by sum of terms, okay, into the number. Okay, number is nothing but whatever the bulk they'll be giving, na, that one. Either it can be amount, or it can be a number, or it can be some cloth, or it can be some weight, whatever it can be, totally what they'll give, na, that is nothing but a number. Okay, so first part, it is equal to, what is the first term now? 3. Sum of the terms, add both the terms. So 3 plus 2. Okay, into number, what is the total thing? 180, okay, which is equal to 3 divided by, what is 3 plus 2? 5, into 180, okay, divided by nothing is there, means divided by 1, okay, so 18 threes are 54, 0, okay, 180 threes are is 540, divided by 5, do the division, children, you do the division in the side work, I will write the direct answer, 5 ones are 5, 0, 5, 8 are 4. If you want, you can do the division in the side work. Okay? So, this is said to be your first part. This formula you should buy it, children. Okay? Next, what is second part? Both the parts they have asked to find, no? So, first part we have found it. What is second part? Same formula, but instead of first term, there you should substitute second term. So, the formula for finding the second part is second term by sum of the terms, okay, into the number, okay, which is equal to, what is the second term now? It is 2 divided by sum of the terms. What are the sum of the terms? 3 plus 2, okay, into, what is the number? Number is 180, which is equal to, okay, so 2 divided by 3 plus 2 is 5, into 180. 180 means 180 by 1, okay, so 182s are, it is 360. If you want, you can multiply. Okay, children, divided by 5 1s is 5. Okay, this one you do the division in the side work. I am writing the direct answer. 5 7s are 35, 1 remainder 10, 5 2s are 10. Okay, 72. So, this is said to be your second part. Okay, children, so totally a bulk amount of 180 rupees. 180 is now distributed into two parts. So, the first part, if we distribute the given amount into two ratios in the into two parts in the ratio 3:2, then first part will be 108 and the second part will be 72. Is it clear, children? So have you understood how to divide anything into two parts? Okay, these formulas you should buy it. Okay, children. In the same way, 12th B question is there, which is very similar to the same problem. Okay, so this one you take as homework. Okay. But instead of some number, they have given in rupees. Okay, all remaining question is same. Okay, so the 12th B question, you take as homework and you try to do it by yourself. Okay, children, so that you can understand the concept very clearly. Okay, so 12th A, whatever I have written on the board, that you copy to classwork. And 12th B, you just do it here by yourself in the homework book. Okay, children. Okay, children, next is 13th question. Okay, 13th A, a rope of length 3 meter, 60 centimeter. It is cut into 2 pieces. So, whenever you find in the question as 2 pieces, 2 parts, okay, like that, then you should apply whatever the formula I have told in the previous class. That is, to find out first part and second part, whatever the formula you will apply now, same thing you should apply, okay. Such that, the ratio of length of the pieces. So, 2 pieces length they have given, ratio. 2 pieces length ratio they have given, okay. So, that is 7:5. Find the length of larger piece. So, the larger piece length we should find now. How to find it out? So, first, ratio we know, correct? So the what is first part, children? The first term, sorry, first term is first term of the ratio 7. Second term, it is the second part, that is 5. Okay, so among 7 and 5, which is larger? 7 is larger. They told to find out the length of the larger piece. So first piece we should find. Okay, children. So it is nothing but the first part we should find out. Have you understood, children? They have given the total rope of length. So total rope length they have given. Total rope length is nothing but the number. The total, whatever the bulk thing they have given, that is nothing but a rope length. Okay. This rope, it has been cut into two pieces. I mean two parts. Those two parts, they are in the ratio 7:5. So the first part, it is nothing but the first term is 7. Okay. And the second term, it is nothing but the 5. Okay. So it has been cut into two parts now. Out of those two parts, the larger part length we should find. Larger part is nothing but the part with the larger term. Okay. Among 7 and 5, which is larger? 7 is larger. So this is going to be the larger part. Okay, which is nothing but the first part. So how to find out the first part? What is the formula, children? The first part, it is equal to, okay, the first term, okay, divided by sum of the terms, okay, into the number. Okay, the first term, which is the first term now? 7. By sum of the terms is 7 plus 5 into the number is a length of the total rope. What is that? 3 meter 60 centimeter. See, it is in 2 units now. So convert it into a single unit. So 1 meter means 100 centimeter. So 300 means 300 centimeter plus 60 centimeter. So what is 300 plus 60? It is 360 centimeter. So total or the bulk amount is 360 now. So multiply by 360, which is equal to 7 by 7 plus 5. It is nothing but 12 into 360. 360 is nothing but 360 by 1. Multiply these two. 7 zeros are 0. 7 6 are 42. 2 for carry. 7 3s are 21 plus 4 is 25 by 12. Do the division, children. 12 2s are 24, 1 remainder 12, 12 1s are 12, 0. Okay. So 210 you'll get. If you have any doubt, okay, you can just do it by yourself. You can do the division in the side work so that you can understand the concept clearly. Okay, children. So the first part is 210 centimeter. Okay, children. So this is said to be your first part. Have you understood, children? How to find it out? Is it clear? Okay. What I have done? Same as the previous question. Divide 180. 180 here is nothing but the total rope length that I have found it. Okay. Next. They have given the rope. It has been cut into two pieces. I mean two parts. Okay. And the ratio of both the parts they have given. That is 7:5. So I have written as first term and second term. They have asked me to find the length of the larger piece. So the larger part length we should find. Larger part means the part with the first term larger. See, the first term is 7. Actually, see, the 7 and 5 among these two, which term is more? 7 is more. So this is said to be the large part. This is said to be the smaller part. So the larger part I should find. So larger part means the first part. This is only the larger part, no? So I have found it. Okay, children. The 13th B question is there, no? It is very similar to the A question. Okay. Only difference is that, see, in that question, the data is related to rice. 80 kg of rice is packed into 2 bags. So, the number here is 80. Okay. 2 bags in the ratio 9:7. So, the first term is 9, second term is 7. Okay. And find the weight of the rice in the lighter bag. Lighter bag means the bag which is not of so much weight. I mean with less weight. Okay. So, compare the terms now. First term is 9, second term is 7. Among first term and second term, which is smaller? 7 is smaller. So, you should find the second part now. So, directly you apply the second part formula. That is, second part is equal to second term by sum of terms into number. and you just find out the second part for 13th B question. Is it clear, children? So have you understood how to solve 13th B? So 13th B question you take as homework, children, and you do this question by yourself in homework book. And 13th A question, whatever I have did on the board, no, this one you copy to class book. Okay, children? Thank you.